Hey YouTube, it's JYDrummer12 with you again. This is part two of my series on sexual purity. On my last video, I talked about introduction and chapter one of Every Young Man's Battle by Stephen Arthur Byrne. And on this video, I'll be talking about chapter two and possibly chapter three if I have time. All right, well, here we go. With chapter two, its title is Distance from God. It goes on with Fred's life a little more, and it talks about his life and what God is doing in his life. And it talks, he had many girlfriends and many sexual partners, and he didn't find anything wrong with his life. He went to church, and sometimes the church pastor would hit his heart, but touch his heart with the message. But for the most part, nothing really affected him, and it felt like, who's the pastor? Who is this person? Like, he has nothing to do. I love my girlfriends. That's how he felt. And after 4 years of school or so, he graduated from Stanford University with a sociology degree, and he got a job as an investment advisor. And one day he stayed late from work, and he was just relaxing for a little while, and he was watching the sunset. It was a real nice day, and out of nowhere, God spoke to his heart, and God gave him a revelation, and God showed Fred how hopeless he was. And during that evening in the office, God showed him his sin, and right there he just started breaking down. He was just completely amazed by what was going on, and he prayed to God. He prayed to God. Oh, right here. Lord, I'm ready to work with you if you're ready to work with me. And right there, that's when the Holy Spirit entered his body. And later in the with this chapter, it kept going on, and he now saw that he needed a Savior, and that Savior is Jesus Christ. And one time after work, after this happened, he got a job in Iowa, and he had some vacation, and he wanted to go to he was going to, on a steamboat to Steamboat Springs, Colorado. I don't know where that is, but I know it's in Colorado, but I don't know where in Colorado, but with some friends, and he had to go to the bathroom on the ride there, and so he stopped off at a place, and he went right to the restroom, and when he walked in, he was just, bang, just exploded. He saw all these, pictures of Playboy centerfolds, and he just was instantly repulsed by it. And like, before, he memorized the date of when the different pornographic magazines would come out, and for him, this is definitely weird, and he didn't notice it at the time, but when he looked back, he could definitely connect the new him, the new Fred, and how God changed his heart, and how amazing it was to actually have that feeling happen to him. And here's a little quote that he's in the book. It talks about, and here it is: when you're saved, God gives you a new heart for Him. He lives in you and gives you the strength you need to do everything and anything He calls you to do, including His call to sexual purity. This new life flowed with no effort from me, and the new inclination to do God's will came without any attention on my part. That's interesting, because it seems like from a man that was addicted to porn and to sex and all this other stuff, that this would be hard, but God's working with him, and he's giving him a way out. And then here's a subtitle. It says the desire to do right. And This is a very interesting story on Fred's part. But one day he was thinking about this old crush he had in high school, and he didn't have time for girlfriends, but he, or a girl that he liked in high school, and he found her, you know, and she invited him over to a dance, and they were alone at the end of the dance, and they ended up going to her apartment, and out of nowhere, you know, one thing led to another, and they went to bed together, and this is pretty funny, but as they were kissing, something happened to him, and he couldn't perform, if you know what I mean. And this has never happened to him, so this is really interesting. And he's like, "What is wrong with me?" And he ended up just leaving, and he went to the car, and he heard a whisper in his heart saying, "By the way, I did that to you. I know it hurt you, but this practice can't tolerate anymore in your life. You are Christ now, and he loves you, and I love you." And he's talking about how you didn't have to say it twice, and this really helped him, because he actually found a girl a couple months later, her name was Brenda, and he was committed in saving intercourse till the wedding night. Well, I'm going to have to do a whole series on chapter 3, a whole part on chapter 3. It's kind of a long chapter, so instead of talking about this book, I'm going to talk about my life and how God's working in my life. As I said before, I was saved about 2.5 years ago, the fall of 2006 or 2007, yeah, one of them. And my life has been completely changed since then. Jesus is definitely in my life and showing me, and I definitely want to be here where I am right now. I'm a freshman in college. I play football, and I'm thinking about majoring in geology, and for the most part, I like college. No, I'm just kidding. I love college, but I'm having a lot of fun here, and I definitely see God's work in all of college and all of all these people. And well, this is the ending of my series in part two of my series. The song that you're hearing right now is by Cutlass, called Strong Tower. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope you have a good day, and I pray for all of you that are watching this. I really appreciate you guys watching my videos, and God bless you all. When I wander through the desert and I'm longing for my home, all my dreams have gone astray. When I'm stranded in the valley and I'm tired and all alone, it seems like I've lost my way. I go running to your mountain, mercy sets me free. You are my strong tower, shelter. All I hear, you speak softly to my soul.